here today to hear us sing, to join us in singing, and to share her some stories about how Christmas is celebrated in their parts of the world.
The first Christmas was in America was celebrated over 200 years ago, way back in 1776. I bet it was a lot different than the way some of us celebrate it, the winter holiday today.
I'm sure it was. They had things like Yule logs and boar's head and figgy pudding. I'm not too sure what figgy pudding is, but I don't think I want any.
Tradition of eating special foods, singing special songs, and all the different ways or our family celebrates the holidays have been passed long from person to person and generation to generation over many years.
Our ancestors had customs and beliefs that they taught their children who taught their children, and so on. Some of us know what our traditions are, and some of us are still learning them. I know in my family a tradition we have is staying up late to watch all the Christmas specials on TV.
Well, I bet that Frosty the Snowman didn't exist 200 years ago, but you're right. We are always adding new traditions, our own personal touches, so I suppose that means we all have some store of tradition, doesn't it?
Come to be from stories and customs have dimly and
Wouldn't it be?
Wouldn't it be cool to go back in time and to see what kinds of traditions kids like us had 200 years ago? I wonder if any of them would be the same.
I don't know, but it would be neat to ask them. But let's think for a minute. Today in our country, there are people from all over the world. Some people came from different countries when they were small, and some were born here.
We live in different places, two cities, farms, towns, villages, depending on where we live or where we came from. We could also speak a different language, have a different accent, or wear a different style of clothing.
Some of us might not even celebrate Christmas, but other winter holidays like Kwanzaa or Hanukkah, as you might imagine, because we are so here's what some of us think of as Christmas, because we could be celebrated in many different ways.
Kwanzaa is a week-long celebration that starts on December 16th, 26th, and ends on January 1st. During this week, African Americans, all along with African Canadians, celebrated their heritage and culture by eating special food, giving gifts, and singing special songs.
Kwanzaa celebrates Nusul Saba, or Seven Presidents' Principles of Africa,
and what?
Heritage.
And where am I at? Dosh.
This principles come from Kwinda, or traditions, and each day of the keep week is dedicated to one the principles and Kuklin unity, self-determination, responsibility, cooperation, purpose, creativity, and faith, a traditional greeting of each day of Kwanzaa is Habari Gani, which is Swahili for what is news.
Thank you.
holiday that is celebrated in many homes throughout our country. Over 8 days and nights of Hanukkah, families will eat delicious food, trade small presents, and play special games.
During the week, long holiday candles are lit in a special holder called a menorah. One candle begins lit per night. The menorah is traditionally placed in a window or near door looking out to the street so that it can be seen by people who walk or drive by.
Many songs have been written for Hanukkah. They include the songs Inked Little Candles, Green, 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 Hanukkah, Oh Hanukkah, and Near Lie, Or I Have a Candle.
No matter what the costumes and traditions are in your families, I'm seeing that there's something we all have in common, and that's singing. Whether our families are big or small, whatever we believe or whatever we celebrate, we all just love sharing our Christmas or Kwanzaa or Hanukkah spirit in song.
But Christmas wasn't always a happy time. For the first Christmas in 1776, many families weren't able to be together. As one, so many people were far away spending Christmas fighting for our freedom.
And our country has fallen on hard times too. As a matter of fact, as great Depression started shortly before the holiday season back in 1929. Families had very little money and had a hard time buying good foods and clothes, for Christmas.
Despite all this, we're learned to make do, and for many of us, we have learned that Christmas isn't about the stuff that we get, but more about who we spend it with. Gathering with family and friends, eating good food, sharing stories, and singing songs is sometimes more memorable that the toys will forget about and stop playing within a couple months of years.
We agree that it's always nice to get things, but sometimes it's nicer to give and share with others during the holiday season too. Thanks to our student council, all of us here at Indian Woods were able to share with others this holiday season. Over the past couple weeks, each class in the school put together a quilt to give to another child who needed one. I would like to introduce Miss Misty, who will say a few words before our quilts are delivered.
The student council officers up, please.
Right now. Come on, move. I thought that you're helping.
Avery.
Come on, Don, let's go. Come on. You don't want me to keep bending over.
Good afternoon.
don't know about you, but I have sure have some great memories of our performance. This afternoon, we got together with friends, family, teachers, neighbors, everyone. We sang some songs, shared some stories, and maybe, just maybe, I'll be able to get a treat for a job. Well done. Ice cream sundaes.
No matter what Christmas is, winter means to you and families, I'm sure that you'll have some great memories too, even if it's just going outside and building a snowman.
We sure do. Thank everyone again for joining us and hope that you have a wonderful Hanukkah or Kwanzaa or Christmas, wherever it is you celebrate. What you have a wonderful holiday. And of course, a very happy new year.
I love how our students ran our assembly today. Nice job. And we threw them a little curve when they had their surprise visitor, but that's what the holidays are all about. Having fun and enjoying ourselves with our families. We are so pleased that so many of our families took time out of their busy schedules to come today and spend time watching our children. Busy schedules to come today and spend time watching our children. The teachers have asked that the children be allowed to come back to class. They do have some few things to wrap up. So if you absolutely do need your child at this time, we're asking that you check them out through the office, the normal procedure that we have. We're going to start with Mrs. Toon's class. They've already left us.